वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल अवनीश सूर्या वीलॉग। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर द ब्रीफ हिस्ट्री एंड ए स्टोरी ऑफ HDFC बैंक। HDFC बैंक इज टुडे इंडियाज लार्जेस्ट प्राइवेट सेक्टर बैंक फ्रेंचाइजी। ग्लोबली एज ऑफ 2 अप्रैल 2016 HDFC Bank is the only Indian bank to feature in the list of the top 50 largest banks in the world. Well, execution has made HDFC Bank stand apart from other banks. It has done this without any compromise on the quality of its loans and with a focus on profitability, thereby maintaining a high quality of loan book and high net interest margin. So friends, if you have not subscribed my YouTube channel Avnish Surya Vlog yet, please subscribe immediately to know about the corporate world, society and the informations around the world. Housing Development Finance Corporation or HDFC was started in 1977 by Hasmukhbhai Parekh, who was the chairman of ICICI Bank in 1972. Parekh's nephew Deepak Parekh took over as managing director of HDFC in 1994. When HDFC received its banking license from the RBI in 1994, it was Deepak Parekh who hired Aditya Puri to run this newly formed bank. Puri was heading Citibank's Malaysia operations that time, and he was a rising star in Citibank, and he was also among the 50 executives worldwide identified by Citibank's chairman and CEO. It took a lot of persuasion from Parekh to convince Puri. Aditya Puri built most of his team by hiring young bankers from Citibank, Bank of America, Hong Kong and Shanghai Banking Corporation (HSBC). HDFC Bank started providing innovative solutions to cooperative banks through the novel check settlement system in 1998. HDFC Bank was the first among Indian banks to have a centralized system. HDFC Bank used these systems to build its business in two different ways: garner low-cost corporate deposits and earn cash management fees. The bank's cash management business registered 40% CAGR revenue between FY01 and FY11. Current account deposits accounted for 33% of its deposits by the end of FY 2000. The focus on blue chip corporates and lower funding helped HDFC Bank derive higher net interest margins. The bank was acutely aware of its opportunities that lay in retail banking, taking savings deposits from customers and in turn providing them loans like car loans, credit cards, etc. Moreover, the bank did not really have the branch strength before 2000 because branch licensing was not easy in those days, as the RBI used to issue only a limited number of licenses. The acquisition of Times Bank in February 2000 brought retail banking and also increased the bank's branch count by 35. HDFC Bank's strategy revolved around superior technology and solutions to clients. In January 2000, HDFC Bank became the first bank in India to launch mobile banking. Over FY 2008, the bank expanded its branch network at a CAGR of 27% and its ATM network at a CAGR of 43%. By the end of FY08, HDFC Bank had 761 branches compared to 37 a decade ago. Loan against shares was the first product launched by the bank in FY98, as it was a natural extension for the bank given its experience in central capital market related settlements. In FY99, it launched car loans, and in FY2000, personal loans and loans for IPOs. From 2001, the bank started focusing on increasing the number of products and on geographical expansion. By the end of March 2000, the bank was offering LAS in 20 cities, car loans in 16 cities, personal loans in 10 cities, and consumer durable loans in 3 cities. The number of locations offering consumer loans had doubled by March 2002. By March 2003, the bank started offering credit cards and two-wheeler loans. That year also saw an increase in the number of cities covered. By FY07, the bank had also entered SME lending, agri-financing, rural microfinance loans, tractor loans, and two-wheeler loans. By December 2015, the bank had installed 2,80,000 POS terminals and grabbed 22% market share in this business. HDFC Bank acquired Centurion Bank of Punjab (CBOP) in May 2008 for one share of HDFC Bank for every 29 shares of CBOP. CBOP had most of its branches in Punjab and Kerala, where HDFC Bank had a weak presence. CBOP was also a strong rural franchisee due to its strong presence in Punjab, and was also strong in two-wheeler loan lending. HDFC used this acquisition to build its net rural banking franchise and leadership position in two-wheeler loans. Over FY09 to 15, the bank's retail loan book posted a 20% CAGR compared with industry growth rate of 13%. By FY15, the bank was the top retail lender in the country. The bank had started expanding its footprint in non-metro cities right from the early 90s. HDFC Bank now has a presence in all major rural loan segments like microfinance loans, gold loans, two-wheeler loans, tractor loans, etc. The bank started a major push towards digital banking, as the increase in mobile network speed enabled many services to move online. In FY15, HDFC Bank introduced various products to take on the companies focused on financial technology. It launched mobile wallet PayZap to counter mobile wallets like Paytm and MobiWeek. The bank also launched 10-second pre-approved personal loans for existing customers, the first such product in India. So thank you friends. If you liked my this video and the story, please subscribe our YouTube channel Avni Surya Vlog to stay updated with the corporate world, society, books, countries, etc.